Hi everyone. Today we're going to look at a few different ways to combine different documents into one PDF. Some of you may need to do this to assemble an end of semester portfolio for your class so you can turn one document into your professor at the end of the semester. This video is really for situations where you have different types of documents or files that you need to combine. So for example, maybe you have papers, but also presentation, also some images, a situation like that. If you have only all Word documents or only all PowerPoint files, for example, your best bet is just to copy and paste those documents into one file and save that as a PDF. So for today, we're going to assume you have different types of files that you need to join together. The first step in this process is to get all the files you need in PDF form. If you're in any Microsoft Office program, like Word or PowerPoint, there's a Save as PDF option, usually in the File menu, or File tab if you're on a PC. On the PC, you go to the Save and Send section, and then there's a Create PDF option. On the Mac, you can just do Save as PDF. If this is a Google Drive document, just go to the File menu and say Download as PDF. This step should be pretty simple. So then make sure all the documents end up on your computer in a place you can find them, preferably in one folder, all together. Now this is an optional step, but I do recommend it. You'll see that I created an additional document that has a title page, a list of the documents in the portfolio, and section titles to go between each piece in the portfolio. Adding this information in is going to make the portfolio a little more navigable, and your faculty will likely appreciate this. So now we'll get into the different ways to combine these into one PDF. The easiest way by far is on a Mac, using the built-in preview application. So here's how it works in preview. I'm going to start by opening each of my PDFs with preview. So if it's not set to be the default, you might have to do an open with and then preview. And I'm going to do each of these individually because if you select more than one and you open with preview, it'll put them all in the same preview window, which gets very confusing when you are trying to move them and combine them. So just do it one at a time. It'll be much easier to deal with. So just do open with until you have them all open. Now what I have here is I have the pages I created just in Microsoft Word. That's my title page, and I have a table of contents and some headings, and then I have the actual essays. And so let's take a look at how to combine them. So I'm gonna start just with this one page, that's my title. And then I want to add in the next page, and I want to make sure that I can see my thumbnails, which I can. And then what I do is I just grab this first page and I drag it over, and I want to put it so I see that little plus on top of the first page of the portfolio title page. And when I let go, you'll see that it added it in. It gave this page number 2, so I know that it's adding it in and is part of the same PDF. If, for example, it ended up underneath this line right here, that's actually not combining it into a new PDF. It's just viewing two PDFs, two documents in the same window, and that's where it gets confusing. So I'll just close that one, but as long as you can see the page numbers going in sequence, that actually is all part of the same PDF. So I would then just keep working my way through. Okay, here's the title page for my first essay. Then let me actually open the PDF for the essay. Now, because this one has multiple pages, I want to make sure I can see all the thumbnails, and I want to select all the pages in the thumbnail. So I'm going to click the first one, then I'm going to hold down the Shift key on my keyboard and click the third, and that'll select them all. And now I can just drag them on in, make sure they go here above that little line. Okay, gave them the right page numbers, that's good. Maybe it's time for my presentation now. Find my thumbnails, make sure all the slides are selected, and drag them over. And again, always make sure it puts it above that line and gives it page numbers. So at this point, I can do a save as or a save, and this will now be a PDF with all these pages. Now there's one additional thing I can do in preview, which is to make this PDF smaller. So if I save my file and I realize that it's really huge, like, you know, 10, 20, 30 megabytes, if I go to the File menu and then Export, and then under Filter, if you say Reduce File Size, This will make that file smaller. What it's going to do, though, however, is making the images that you have in here a lower resolution. They're going to look more pixelated, so you can decide if this is going to work for your project or not, or try it and see how it looks. If you're on a Windows computer, you have a few options. One is to use a website, which is called Merge PDF, and here's the link. They do have a limit of 30 megabytes per each PDF that you upload to start with, so if it's larger than that, you might have a problem, but otherwise this should work fine. You just upload your stuff, set the order, it's got a lot of obnoxious ads, but otherwise it works okay, and then you can combine the PDF and download it. Another option for Windows is that there's a couple free programs that you would download to your computer that seem fine. One is called PDF Converter Free. Here's the website for that. Another is called Batch PDF Merger, and they work kind of the same way. You just pick your PDFs and then it will combine them together. They seem to work okay. Now, if you want to get a little more slick and add links into your document to the various sections in it, so you get an interactive table of contents, you'll need to use Acrobat Professional, which is the more advanced, non-free version of Adobe Reader. On the Hampshire campus, there are computers in the lab on the third floor of the library that have this program, so you can use that anytime, or you can download a 30-day trial to your own computer from Adobe if you want to give it a shot. You can also use Acrobat to combine the PDFs together, so if you're going to be using it anyway, let's look at how to do that first. So again, the first step is having the PDFs on your computer. Then you go into Acrobat, choose Create here, and then Combine Files. Then you pick your files, get them in the right order. I'm going to add in my section title pages here also. I have them as individual PDFs. And then you just click Combine. It'll show you the file that has everything together, and then you save that. To add links, I'm going to go to the page that had the table of contents. And again, this is just a PDF I created in Microsoft Word and added in to the PDF. And if you highlight one of these names and then do a right click and say create link, make sure it says go to a page view and then click next. And then just actually navigate in the document to whatever page you want it to go to. So it might be page, 6 or 7, and then say set link. And now when someone is viewing the PDF, this should work in any PDF viewer, not if they're just using Acrobat. If they click this link, they should go to that page. This is the main thing that the free options can't do. Though if you find something that can do it, please let me know. Another good thing to use Acrobat for is to get the size of your PDF under control. So again, if you save this and the file is totally huge, what you can do here in Acrobat is you can say save as, and then you want to pick PDF optimized. So this is similar to what you can do in Preview, but in Acrobat, you can really customize the settings, and you can specifically say what resolution you want images to be. So you could have the images still look okay, other things be sized down. So this gives you a little bit more control if you really want to get in and be specific about the resolution. So for images, anything 300 or above, they still should look decent, but it still should also reduce the size of the file. So good luck with all of this, and let me know if you have any questions.